Welcome back, my friends. Well, from one type of superstar to another, a year ago, our next guest released the audiobook Possibilities Lined in Chalk, and this weekend it will be available for print, in print for the very first time. Please welcome back to the show one of my favorite human beings, the great Chris Hawkey, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Question number one.
Yes.
Would you like to sing some opera?
Is it okay if we play a little Pantera?
Yeah.
Anybody gonna throw
Maestro,
some stuff on there?
Pantera,
anybody
want that please.
Music for you? Yeah. That was beautiful.
Did it not sound like a CD?
It sounded great, and also she was making some delicious dessert. That's a dream come true for
yeah.
me. I've had dreams like that.
You need to get her on the power trip.
I could not agree more.
Yeah. By the way, let me start with this. We'll get to your book.
Don't worry, it's fine. I got
Let me just say that I take special pride, even though we're competitors in the morning. Nothing makes me happier than when I see you guys recently had an event the day after Thanksgiving.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And you guys had, before dawn, you had hundreds and hundreds of listeners lined up for your events. You're the biggest station, right? Am I get this right? Mm. The biggest, don't be humble, the biggest sports station in the country, right?
Yeah, we do really well. And I can't believe it because, as you well know, I don't even like sports, and it makes for kind of a weird segment. But no, in all seriousness, it's been a great run. And we're the youngest show on the station. We've been on the air for 20 years now. That was the celebration we were having. And you know, because right before that, you and I were doing radio together on the FM side as well. So it's just been great. And we have a community of people, just like you do, who are dedicated to the show. And they become more than listeners. They become friends and family. It's great.
There's something special that can, and it sounds cheesy, and it sounds like we're, but there's a very special connection with TV as well.
Sure.
But radio is a different beast.
It is. You become part of their lives and part of their family. I've talked to people all the time who say, I listened to you with my dad when I was going to elementary school, and now I listen to you in college. And that's just a great thing. What a privilege, right?
It is.
I love doing the job. Our job is to go try to make our friends laugh every morning. How lucky are we?
We both share the same appreciation.
Yeah.
We're very lucky. Let's talk about this. You were here. I love it.
How about it?
For folks that missed the last time you were here, what's the book about, my friend?
Well, I grew up in a very small town, right on the border of Indiana and Ohio, and I had such a great group of friends in a small town, and I look back on those times before cell phones, before all the pressures that these kids have today, with just such reverence. So this is my version of the Wonder Years. You know, this is my fictional telling of what it was like to grow up in a small town before all the social media and stuff like that, and to be concerned about something as small as football and math tests so much that you thought it was the be-all of your life. And so that's what the book's about. I had an idea for a story. It took me forever to write it. Turned it into an audio book last year, as you mentioned. And some friends, Andrea Yock, some friends got together and said, let's make this into a book. People seem to like it. So Bell Bank helped me make it into a real book. And now we're selling it for Best Christmas Ever. Every dime of every sale goes to Best Christmas Ever. So I'm really happy that we're able to do that, and I hope somebody likes it.
Will you tell the folks what Best Christmas Ever, what's about?
Yeah, and you know me, I'm an emotional guy, so I'll try not to get emotional. But Abigail, our youngest, is 18 this year. She's off to college, 19. She's off to college now. So I'm an empty nester. We're an empty nester. I love Christmas so much. I've always loved Christmas so much. Wasn't sure what to do without any kids in the house. Alex has been gone for a long time now. He's out in Seattle. So found this charity by chance in the summertime called Best Christmas Ever, where it's not just about getting toys and such to make it a great Christmas, which is a great thing too, but these people literally change people's lives. So people nominate families who are having terrible circumstances through no fault of their own.
Yeah.
Their house is burned down, a terrible disease or something like that. And then team captains like myself choose a family. You're given the family, and then you not only get them toys for Christmas, you try to change their life as much as you can. You raise money, so pay people's rent, pay off their car. One family lost their house to a fire. They're in a house now, thanks to Best Christmas Ever. So we were able, because of things like the book and other sponsors and families and this event we have going on tomorrow, we have two families this year. So I don't have babies at home anymore to reward and give gifts. This is how I'm celebrating Christmas this year.
We have just under a minute. I wanted to ask you, we said during the break, every time I look, you're onto something new, you're onto a different project. What motivates you?
The amount of things I get to do. You know, I know I'm the luckiest guy ever, and I'm going to wake up every day and do my best to deserve it.
Yeah.
That's my motivation right
now. I love you, buddy.
I love you, brother. I do.
Chris Hawkey, everybody. The Hawkey Holiday Village is Saturday. I love it. He has a holiday village, for heaven's sake.
Yes.
Is Saturday at the Rock Elm Tavern in Plymouth from 11 to 2. And as Chris said, it benefits Best Christmas Ever. And I don't need to tell you that. If you're not listening to me, for heaven's sake, in the morning, go ahead and listen to Chris on KFAN.
When you go to commercial, people turn to us and they go right
back. Vice versa.
That sounds good to me.
Tell Lieber I said hi.
I will do that.
We'll be back right after this. Back in a moment. I was on Lieber's podcast. This holiday season, let's celebrate our